In this video, we're going to take a look at subqueries that are being used inside of a where clause. Now, this is where subqueries start to get really, really useful. So we're going to spend a good amount of time to study some different types of subqueries and some rules around them, and then eventually start to write out some interesting queries. So the last couple of videos, when you're talking about from and joins with subqueries, not quite as useful. You're not going to see them used quite as often. You're going to see subqueries used inside of where statements a little bit more frequently. But of course, it always comes down to the kind of application you are building. Okay, anyways, let's get to it. So in this example, we are talking about using subqueries inside of a where clause. So we really have to think back to how where clauses work in general. Remember, we are going to use where clause to filter out some number of rows. There are a couple of different operators we can use inside of a where clause. Stuff like greater than, less than, equal to, greater than or equal to, in, not in, couple others we discussed way back inside of section one. So when we start talking about subqueries being used inside of a where clause, and we start to think about the type or structure of data that is returned from the subquery, a valid subquery is going to be valid or not depending upon the operator right here that we are using. So in some cases, we are allowed to write a subquery that is going to return only one single value. In other cases, if we use a different operator, we might be allowed to write a subquery that's going to return a list or a single column of values. It all comes down to the operator that we are using. I'm going to show you a full list of different operators that we would use inside of a where clause and the different types of data that we are allowed to return from a subquery in just a moment. But for right now, let's just take a look at this first example. So in this first example, we're going to try to write out a query where we're going to show the ID of orders that involve a product or is an order for a product with a price to weight ratio greater than 5. Now, I want to point out once again that we could technically solve this query by using a join, just a normal join. And you're going to see that's somewhat frequent or kind of common with a lot of subqueries that we might put into a where clause. You might be able to solve it using a join. But in general, understanding a where with a subquery sometimes ends up being a little bit easier than understanding a join expression. So even though we can sometimes use them interchangeably a little bit, well, sometimes it's just easier to use a subquery inside of your where. Okay, so back to the problem at hand. If we're going to solve this using a subquery, the first thing we might want to do is try to list out all the different products with a price to weight ratio greater than 5. And this subquery right here would do it. Let's run just that subquery by itself really quickly and verify that. Okay, so we might do something like select ID from products where the price divided by the weight is greater than 5. So if we run that, we'll see a list of all the different product IDs where their price divided by the weight is greater than 5. You'll notice that the vast majority of records here do have a ratio that is greater than 5. So if you want to, you could always change this to something like 300, and you'll definitely get a much reduced set here. Maybe something like 50 would be a little bit better. Yeah, that's better. Now we're definitely missing some IDs inside of here. So you'll notice that we are getting back a single column of values. If we get back a single column of values, then we are allowed to use that with an in operator. The in operator, you might recall, is going to check and see whether or not this value right here is present inside of a list of values. So in this case, we are checking to see if a product ID is present inside of the list of IDs that we just got back from the subquery. Let's take a look at this in diagram format. Okay, so here's our table of orders and products. We're going to first imagine what happens with the subquery right here. So in this case, we can imagine that we're going to take a look at all the different products, and we're going to discard any product that has a price divided by weight less than 5. Sorry, did that math for us. This is not exact math, but it's close enough for the purposes of this diagram. So we'd go through here and remove any record with a price to weight ratio less than 5. Well, looks like in this case, it's just the one right there. So we would delete that row. Then out of all the remaining rows, we're going to select just the ID column and nothing else. So all these other columns are going to fall away, and we are left with just this list of values right here. After that, that column or that list of values will be provided to the where clause. So now we're going to take a look at every product ID from the orders table. And we are only going to keep around product IDs where the ID is present inside of this list right here. So we can now imagine that the database is going to go through row by row and check and make sure that this value is present in this list. In this case, it is. So we would keep the first row around. The next value is definitely present. The next one is definitely present. And then 3 right here is definitely not present. 3 is not inside of this list of IDs. So we would drop off that row entirely. And then finally, product ID 1. Yep, it's right there. So that is our final data set right there. We have gone through the entire where clause at this point. And so that now the last thing for our database to do is just select the columns that we actually care about. In this case, it is just ID. So all these other columns would fall away. And we are left with just these IDs right here. Okay, so now that we understand the kind of backstory here and we understand the subquery, let's go write the entire query, so the outer and the inner together. All right, so back over here, I'm going to start from scratch. I'm going to select the ID from orders, and I only want to see orders where the product ID of the order is present in a list. So we're going to use that in keyword. And then we're going to provide that list using a subquery. So inside the subquery parentheses, we'll put in select. And excuse me, wait, let's see, do I have this right? Yep, we got it right. Okay, we're going to select the ID from products where the price of the product divided by the weight is greater than 50 in this case. If we just saw a moment ago, if we use 5, we get too many results. So we'll just go with 50. All right, so let's run this now. And now in theory, these are all the different orders that are for a product with a price to weight ratio greater than 50. Okay, so what we've really learned here is that the different operators that we use are going to influence the structure of data that we are required to return from the subquery. I'm going to give you a more exhaustive list of how the different operators match up to the structure of data coming back in just a moment. The other thing I want to mention here yet again is that technically we could have operated or implemented this entire query right here using a join expression instead. We could have written in a join and then still done a very similar where, and everything would have worked as expected. It's totally up to you whether you want to implement queries like this using a where clause subquery or doing a join. At the end of the day, I think that you'll find that in many scenarios, the performance between the two is actually equivalent. We're going to go into more of this later on inside the course, but all you need to really understand right now is that whenever you provide some SQL to Postgres, it's going to analyze the structure of SQL you put together and try to really understand what you are trying to do. In many cases, Postgres is going to actually rewrite your query for you. And so if you rewrote this as a join expression instead, then it turns out that, well, Postgres might execute the two different queries in exactly the same way. And so you might end up with some identical performance characteristics between the two. That is a discussion we'll have later on inside the course, however. Okay, so pause right here. We're going to take a look at the different operators we can use and the different types of data that we're going to return for each of them as well.